cheapskate across the road to get to church. That's it.
What?
That's good. So we're preacher's kids, and that means we send 60% more than the average person, according to some research done by a stereotype research group. So over the years, we've noticed some aspects in our life that differ from the average person. You know, the average person, you all, that sends 60% less than us. So here's just 10 of those little aspects in our life. Number one, I have mastered the art of manipulation, you know, like a good Christian would do. For example, so whatever restaurant I'm craving on a Sunday afternoon, I'm going to get that restaurant.
How do you get it, Seth?
Thanks for asking. So there's this lovely couple in my church, Jeff and Sherry, love them to death, but I use them for food quite often. So I'll go up to Jeff and I'll be like, hey, Jeff, how's Pizza Hut sound?
I don't care.
Perfect. So now I got to get his wife on board, Sherry. So I'll go up to Sherry and be like, hey, Sherry, Jeff really wants some Pizza Hut.
Third time this month, but sure.
Perfect. Now I got to get Pastor Danny on board. So I'll go up to Pastor Danny. I'll be like, hey, Dad, Jeff and Sherry invited us to Pizza Hut. I think we should go.
Fellowship, I guess. Boom. Number two. Now, often our Pastor Daddy will show a short video to enhance the message of his sermon. Now, this only applies to us because we are the only ones to turn off the lights in the sanctuary, ever.
For example, I could just be in the bathroom, and he'd still just wait for me to come out, because apparently I'm the only one able to hit the light switch in the church.
It's kind of our thing.
Number three, we don't get invited to parties. So, because they know when we get to the party, it's just going to die, because we're going to go to the corner, drink some water, and read our Bibles, and they're going to have no idea what to do with us, so they just don't invite us.
Saves a lot of hassle. And their water. Number four, on the topic of invitations, usually when we invite our friends to church, they come up with the excuse,
my mommy wouldn't drive me.
Yeah, we don't have that excuse. We live approximately 10 feet from our church, which would normally be past my walking limit, but on Sunday mornings, that's not a valid excuse, so I am told.
Number five, we are dealers. Hold your horses. We don't deal drugs. We deal hard candies and caramels that have been in people's coat pockets since the Christmas of 04.
Chewy. Number six, baptism. Holy Spirit's telling me it's pronounced baptism. Probably wrong. Anyway, this doesn't apply to all preachers' kids. We just kind of got unlucky. When we were baptized, it was in a really ratchet horse trough at -30-degree water. So all I heard when I was getting baptized was,
I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son,
and then I got out because it was really cold.
Number seven. Me and Levin play sports. So sometimes when we get home from practice, we come home to about 100 people that we've never seen before in our life. So that means there's a dinner going on. So we're stuck with the job of setting up about 50 tables, scooping about 1,000 scoops of mashed potatoes onto the 7-year-old trays that they eat with reused plastic spoons, and if they're lucky, a spork from KFC.
We like to keep those. Number eight. We have, as preacher's kids, have gotten very good at predicting how Pastor Daddy's services will go. For example, my favorite game to play is called Let's All Stand. This is where I will try and say in unison with my father, let's all stand, his most famous three words. Here's how this would usually go. He'll go up in front of the pulpit, he'll be hooping and hollering like a good Pentecostal does, he'll spit on the front row people, for some reason they still sit there. He'll come on back behind the pulpit and wipe off the sweat, he'll look at the clock, and then in unison from the back with him, I will say, let's all stand. Number nine. Now we're all Pentecostal here, I would think. So I can tell this joke and you all get it. We all respond to the Holy Spirit differently. But there was one response in particular that just terrified us as children. And when our nanny,
that's our grandma,
went up for prayer, she would get hit by Mr. H.S.
Holy Spirit.
And she would scream
really loudly.
So to combat this as children, we would just...